let's go right.
So hello, welcome to today's video. Today I'm gonna set up the springs, the HyperPro springs that I've installed in a previous video. The springs come with a manual and they also have specs for the static sack in there. So I'm gonna check if they're set up correctly today and adjust them if needed. And after that, hopefully we're gonna ride. So these are the spec sheets that come with the springs. On the front side, the sack should be 35 millimeters static sack, plus or minus 5 millimeters, and on the rear it should be 20 millimeters plus or minus 5 millimeters. So I have an old school foldable ruler, so I'll attach that to the front leg of the bike, or the front of the... So I have an old school ruler, foldable ruler. I'll attach that to the fork. And then when I take the bike off the center stand, I can measure the static sack and see if I need to adjust anything or not. So I have a small machine square, and I will use that on top of the triple trees to make sure that I measure the correct distance. And so, come down a little bit. So, I take it off the center stand. And then under its own weight, see how far it drops. You should actually take two measurements. One is when you lift the bike and let it come down gently, so I'll do that first. But let's see. It's a bit of a hustle by yourself, but that's 34 millimeters. Now do the same. Compress this spring and let it come up gently. And it's 48 millimeters. So bike back on the center stand. 48, 34. 39. So that's right in the center spot of the right in the sweet spot, a bit on the soft side of the suggested sack. So what I will do, I will take out the spring and put a little bit of additional preload on it, because I currently have an empty tank. There's only 4 or 5 liters of fuel in it, so I would rather be on the top range, so let's say 33 or 30 millimeters of sack at this point. So, after I do the spring. So I got the spring out, and I'm gonna increase the preload by 5 millimeters. I'm not sure if you can see, but there's a small Allen key here, or small Allen. You need to loosen that before you can increase the preload. Okay, and there's just one in there. Check the current preload. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna measure this thread so I know where I'm gonna end up. So it now almost 16, so I'm gonna increase it to 20. let's see where we are now. $17 million. $18 million. Now let's try that. Tighten the Allen key. Don't forget to do that. Put it back in the bike and then we'll see. Now we're gonna repeat the same. So now we take the bike back off the center stand and redo the test. Redo the measurement. So the upper position, it's now 30 millimeters. And the lower is 40. So average, I'm dead on 35. Might have gone a little bit higher because the tank is empty, but let's take this as a starting point. So I'll tighten the bolt and then we check the rear. For the rear, there's a special instruction to measure. So you measure from the center of the axle of the rear wheel to the pivot point of the swing arm. You translate that measurement to a point on the frame or on the bike. And then you measure that distance and determine the sag for both the high and the low. Take the bike off the center stand again and then make the high and low measurements, see where we end up. So now I need to walk around the bike. It's only 10 mil. Now see what the low one is. The low one is roughly 12 mil, so it's a bit on the high side. Let's see if I can adjust that. And 12. So that's 14, a little bit on the hard side of preload, but I will test ride the bike like this and then make any adjustments as needed.
So here we are finally riding, seeing how it feels. Definitely does already feel a lot smoother than the stock suspension, the one that was on the bike for almost 25 years. But yeah, this is of course smooth asphalt or smooth tar, however you want to call it. And that's not a real test, of course. Gonna get some speed bumps in a little bit, so. Careful for the horse. bit stiffer on the front end. Change the preload up to the original setting, and I immediately feel that the bike feels a lot taller, which is nice. Now let's see how the bike feels, whether it feels more in balance or not. Really, it makes such a difference in terms of ride height. Just for my personal feel, it feels like the bike is like 5 centimeters higher, which of course is stupid because the preload adjustment is maybe just a centimeter. Oh, got the fuel. And yeah, now we're gonna ride the last bit of the rotte. That's also the bit that's unpaved, so that's actually where I expect a bit of a real test for the bike. For the suspension. I took off on the back end, I took off a little bit of the preload, about 25% of this between the stripes, so marginal, and I added 2 clicks of what is it? Rebound damping, because I felt that some of these speed bumps it felt a bit too much like a pogo stick. It does feel smoother than the stock suspension. It feels less like a pogo stick. I was also debating whether I should rebuild the original shocks or not. Decided not to do that, because at the end of the day the price for the rebuild was about and the progressive springs was about 900 euros, 850, 900 more or less, and the new springs, the street box from HyperPro, was a little over 1100, so there was only a 200 euro price difference. But the springs from HyperPro, the street box, they also come with rebound dampening control, so that's 2 clicks I just adjusted. And I believe on the original shocks you only had that at the rear, if it was even functioning at all. So yeah, that's at the end of the day why I decided to go for new stuff, because then you know it's good. The install was pretty simple, so okay, it took a bit of time, but not too bad. Pretty happy with it. If you enjoyed this video, put a thumbs up. If there's anything you want to know, drop a comment down below. If you're not subscribed yet, you can always do that. And I will see you the next time. Bye.